submission on constitutional law. On constitutional law, my submission is that the House needs to be complete insofar as possible. There are exigencies as articulated by my Lord Justice Munib Akhtar, where people may die, people may resign, people may decide to retire and submit a resignation. And then the Constitution provides how those are to be filled in, as happens in the case of vacancies on this Honorable Court. And that does not make the court dysfunctional, but there is also a period where these seats cannot be filled in, as articulated by my Lord Justice Munib Akhtar, and that too is provided for in the Constitution. Over here, the proportional representation system is based on a proportionate division between the political parties. The independents, to start with, are excluded from the mix. To take my Lord Mr. Sayyid Mansoor Ali Shah's example, if in a house of 236, there were to be two political parties and 234 independents, because the proportion is in terms of the constitution between the political parties, it may sound extreme, but my submission on the language of the constitution is that the reserved seats will be divided equally between them.
But what we're not reading in this is the seats secured by them in the General Assembly. So the general seats secured by them. So these two political parties, the next question would be, these two political parties have secured how many seats in the House?
Yes.
And then if they've secured one each, they would have a corresponding share in the reserve. That's it. If they have 100 seats each, then they'll have a corresponding share in the reserve seats. But they can't just take the whole lot just because they're a political party.
Lord, if that were to be correct, then with great respect, may I submit what will happen? That if there are 20 independents, because they do not represent a political party and they're excluded from the proportionate distribution, then those number of reserved seats will have to go vacant each time.
Yes.
So,
yes.
But that is...
So,
historically,
Mr. Badu,
to start...
The question, as I said, is a unique question because this would not have arisen because of the complexion of the independents in the scheme. So we'll have to probably rely on which is a more sacrosanct and a higher principle. Is representativeness a higher principle, or is leaving some seats vacant another principle? Which is a higher principle? Could proportional representation, which comes out of the Constitution, not a higher principle that must be ensured at all times, and vacant seats would be a secondary principle which we can live with, but the other one cannot compromise or trump the other?
My Lord, may I respectfully say the Constitution says, in accordance with law, through proportional representation of political parties' lists of candidates on the basis of total number of general seats. So independents are out. Now, let us say if there are 100 independents and they don't join any political party, what is to be done with the 60 seats for women? Are they to be proportionately reduced? That can be one way of looking at the Constitution. My respectful submission is no, because the House needs to be complete insofar as possible.
At the risk of, when you're completing the House, at the risk of changing the representativeness, that's a higher principle being offended.
No, my Lord. No, my Lord. With respect, may I submit, no higher principle gets offended.
Mr. Khan just started. When you're talking about principles, please can you refer to the Constitution where this is listed?
No, the Constitution over here recognizes...
Is the concept of principle mentioned in the Constitution?
We're expounding the Constitution.
I'm just asking the learned counsel, is it or not?
My Lord, my submission is that it is not.
But there is a principle. Please read Article 5.2.
Yes.
No, yes. Please read it. Let's yes, karke hum isko itna aram se nazarandaz na karein.
Obedience to the Constitution and law is the inviolable obligation of every citizen, wherever he may be, and of every other person for the time being.
This is the only principle enunciated in the Constitution, and I hope you don't mind my saying so. We are so indulgent of autocratic rule, aur aap bhi reh chuke hain dictator ke attorney general. Wo waqt tha जब मैंने वकालत छोड़ दी थी, पता नहीं कितने साल, जब तक वो जजेस रिस्टोर नहीं हुए, ठीक है, हम जब भी कोई जमहूरियत आती है तो हम छुरियां निकाल के आ जाते हैं सामने, और जब भी कोई डिक्टेटर आता है तो फौरन उसके साथ हो जाते हैं, मिनिस्टर बन जाते हैं, अटर्नी जनरल बन जाते हैं। असूल की बात करना है तो बड़ा असूल बात करें, सबसे बड़ा असूल ये है आइन का असूल। ये आइन का असूल पे क्यों नहीं गामजन है? ये प्रिंसिपल और वो प्रिंसिपल, वो कंसल थ्योरी ऑफ लॉ, इसी ने तो पाकिस्तान को तबाह करके रख दिया है। अब आप चलें आईनी कोर्ट हैं, आईन की बातें करें, कहाँ लिखा है कि हम फलां प्रिंसिपल इंपोर्ट कर लें, वो इंग्लिस्तान के जज ने क्या कहा है और उसके जज ने क्या कहा। पहले बताएं कि जी इस पे जबान इसकी वाजे नहीं है, आगे बढ़ते हैं, बता दीजिए हम। तो ये आईन तकद्दस है, ये आपकी मर्जी नहीं है कि आप इसको फॉलो करें, नहीं आपको करना लाजिम है। आप पे हम पे डबल लाजम है इसलिए क्योंकि हम ओथ ले लेते हैं कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन का, आप नहीं लेते हो। आई होप यू डोंट माइंड दीज ऑब्जर्वेशंस, बट दीज आर द फैक्ट्स ऑफ, वी टॉक अबाउट हिस्ट्री, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट कंप्लीट हिस्ट्री ऑफ पाकिस्तान। देन
My Lord, may I?
Makhtoom Sahab,
can you respond to this?
Makhtoom Sahab,
we'll give you a break.
Makhtoom Sahab,
Makhtoom Sahab,
ponder over it.
Makhtoom Sahab,
we'll take it up after this.
I welcome it, my Lord.
I think that's the
Makhtoom Sahab. With great respect, today the Constitution is not being upheld. Whatever is happening, everyone knows, and everyone is pretending as if we are only talking about the past. Today, let this court not be seen as complicit. That is why it is so important to secure the rights of the people. Everyone has made mistakes in the past. No one is an angel. But there has to be a resolve to say one day, enough is enough. Today,
we should also acknowledge our mistakes.
As a Supreme Court, today, we have buried our heads in the sand and we don't want to face the reality, but ultimately it will be our responsibility for every human right violation that is happening today, the enforced disappearances. I mean, we don't let them speak. We say that it's a political issue. It is not a political issue.
My Lord,
it is about the Constitution, the grave violations that are taking place. We cannot shut our eyes. And again, I would say, speaking for myself, the most important petition that is pending in this court is regarding the alleged irregularities on 8th of February elections. And it's known to everyone.
My Lord, counsel have their limitations. Your Lordship, sitting at that exalted position, can say things which may expose me to the law of contempt.
I think this calls for a cup of tea.
Thank you.